Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna. My name is Krishna. I am narrating a story about Gajendra. Here we start it. One day when the sun rises, the king of the There was an elephant named Gajendra. He was the king of elephants, and he had many wives and many children. One day, he was feeling very thirsty. So he saw a lake and he wanted to drink water with lots of lilies, lily pads and lotuses. And he went and drank water, and then they started splashing. They started splashing the water. All splashing, splashing. Everywhere the water. Started splashing the water. And then it disturbed the huge crocodile. And it was disturbing the huge crocodile. The crocodile came. And they grabbed it in their feet. And tried to escape, but Gajendra was a land animal, and if he was in land, then he would get even stronger. But if he was in water, he would lose strength. Same thing opposite thing for the crocodile. When it's in water, it will catch even stronger. And when it's in the land, it will get not that much strength. He'll lose strength. So he tried it, then soon his wives left. And he was looking everywhere for help. Actually, the elephant was a special species. In his previous life, he was king in the Dumya. King in the Dumya was once doing meditation. And one day he invited the sage Agastya, and when he was doing a meditation, Agastya, and then because he offended Agastya cursed him to become in his next life to become an elephant. And he begged for goodness, and he said, and Agastya said, "You will be freed by the mercy of Lord Narayan." And then he went, and now his next life he's an elephant. Now the crocodile was also a special species. In his previous life, he was a Gandharva named Huhu. Once. He and his wife was playing in the water, and suddenly Sage Devala was in the same water. He was waist deep. That means he was waist deep. He was waist deep in the water. He was waist deep in the water. He was waist deep in the water. And just for fun, Huhu grabbed the Sage Devala's feet and pulled him down, and Sage Devala was stunned and found out it was Huhu's mischief, and Sage Devala cursed Huhu to be a crocodile. Huhu prayed for forgiveness, and then Sage Devala said that you will be only freed by the mercy of Narayan. And now he was looking, and finally looked up. Then he remembered.
Gajendra was looking for help.
He was looking for help and finally looked up for help. Mm. And then he, as soon as he looked up for help, God made him remember a prayer that he said that he said in his previous life as King Indradumya. That's why he remembered the prayer and he sang the prayer, and his prayers finally reached Vaikuntha, the abode of Narayan. And Narayan, before going to help his devotee, he do something, I don't know what he does, but that time he didn't do anything. He just called his carrier Garuda, and he said, like, go now only, because my devotee is calling me. That's why as soon as Gajendra saw the Lord
has to come, right?
Lord was coming with the Lord was coming on Garuda. He was flying on Garuda, and as soon as Gajendra saw the Lord, he picked up a lotus flower and offered it to the Lord. And the Lord, go now only, because my devotee is calling me. That's why as soon as Gajendra saw the Lord
has to come, right?
Lord was coming with the Lord was coming on Garuda. He was flying on Garuda, and as soon as Gajendra saw the Lord, he picked up a lotus flower and offered it to the Lord. And the Lord got his Sudarshan Chakra and cut the crocodile's hair off, and the crocodile came up and he pulled both out, and the crocodile came out and became a Gandharva, and he offers his prayers and left to his Gandharva Loka, and Gajendra was liberated. He got liberation, got free from birth and death and liberation, and went back to God. Hare Krishna.